Hi, I'm Jen. I have years of experience hiring data analysts, and I've worked as an analyst myself. I know everything your resume needs to really stand out so you can get your next job in analytics. In this video, I'll teach you my top tips that your resume must have and how to communicate them effectively. If you want more career advice, we post new videos every week. So subscribe to the channel and turn on notifications. We'll cover everything about careers and specifically everything you need to get your next job in analytics or another technical career. Let's look at what should be on your resume. I'm going to break this down into two major areas. The first is what you should put on there in terms of content, and the second area is how should you communicate it so it comes across effectively. When we look at the what should be on your resume, the first thing is math or statistical skills. Talk about any training or degrees you have here. What have you done that proves that you have a good mathematical foundation for the job? So think about your education, think about how you can communicate using these skills in a business setting, and that's the type of thing that employers are going to be looking for. The next type of content that must be on your resume is something related to programming skills. If you're getting into analytics, chances are that you have some sort of programming skills, and if you don't, I'd really recommend you taking time to at least learn one of the languages. You can learn them for free. There's plenty of resources online to do this. So whether it's Python, R, SAS, or SQL even, definitely be sure to list programming skills on your resume. And again, when we talk about how to communicate them, we're going to be talking about what have you done to effectively use them in the jobs where you've made use of these skills. Data visualization is the third type of content that you'll need to have on your resume. While it used to be an optional thing or a leading edge type of skill to have, it's become the baseline expectation. You should know how to create static and dynamic reports and how to make sure that they're really communicating that you know what you're talking about and helping other people understand them. So if you don't have these skills today, again, look at plenty of free options that are out there, whether it's Power BI, Excel, Tableau, ClickView, tons of great resources are out there for you to learn these. This is something you definitely want to have on your data analyst resume. The fourth type of content you'll need to communicate is your communication skills. So you may be a great technical wizard, but again, you need to know how to translate this to the business world. You're often going to be sharing the results of your work with people that have no idea what the details behind it are. They probably think there's a little black magic and wizardry in what you're doing. So being able to make it sound simple and clear for them is going to be very important. And so this is definitely a skill you'll want to communicate that you have. If you don't have any of these four skills, take time to learn how to use different ones of them and to develop them on your own time. I'm curious what skills you're working on developing now. You can let me know in the comments below. While we're talking about communication, let's look at the other key part that your resume needs to have. And that's you need to be able to clearly communicate all of those skills that you have as an analyst or a data scientist. So as a hiring manager, I'm always looking for how well people can articulate what they've done before. It helps me also see how they're going to function in the business. So as a hiring manager, I always look at a resume and treat it as though someone had pretty much an unlimited amount of time to put this document together. So they should be able to communicate to me really clearly what their skills are and how they could benefit me. If the resume is full of errors or really technical, I might understand it, but I'll still have concerns that when you're working in the business, that you might not be able to communicate with the people that are more business and less technical. So that really just touched on my second tip, which is being able to communicate in business terms. Use the technical terms where needed. So don't feel like you can't mention the programming languages. Again, I do want to know about those, but turn them into really business terms. What did you do to save money or generate revenue or improve processes or reduce the amount of work time as a result of what you did? Those are the types of things that businesses care about. And even if it goes through an HR rep or a recruiter that doesn't understand the technical details, they'll still be able to read your resume and be impressed by it. So being able to break things down in business terms is really a key skill to have. That leads into my third key way to communicate on your resume. Tell me how you're going to help me. And this doesn't mean that I want you to say, I did help this company buy blah, 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 and don't just put it in the cover letter. Tell me through the skills that you choose to highlight on your resume what you're gonna do for me. If I'm hiring you as an analyst because I need to predict future failures or predict the future cost of a product, tell me how you've done that before. How have you predicted failures or predicted cost or predicted anything for that matter? Anything that you can do to correlate your past work with the expectations of the job I'm hiring you for is really going to help me see the connection and see what you're gonna do for me. In this video, I focused on the specific skills and communication methods that you'll need on your data analyst resume, but there's some other things that you'll wanna keep in mind on any resume you write, data analyst included. So if you want to know more about applicant tracking systems, which are gonna screen your resume before they make it to me as a hiring manager or even to the recruiter, then check out my video. I've linked it so you can find out how all of this stuff is processed by a computer before it makes it to a person. It makes sense that, especially when we're working in jobs that are technical and make people's lives easier, of course our resumes are gonna go through the same process. If you're looking for a new job and want to know the most critical steps you can take to make it a success, I've linked to my cheat sheet below. It'll walk you through the top items that you must do to land your next job. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you come back and check us out in future videos.